The Daily Beast is reporting tonight that President Trump's use of the phrase horseface a couple of days ago, referring to the adult film actress Stormy Daniels, was not an accident. In effect, the Daily Beast says the tweet was road tested with friends and advisors, and according to the report, he thought it was politically brilliant. This is what he posted about Daniels after a federal judge had dismissed her defamation lawsuit against him. Quote, great, he said. Now I can go after horseface and her third-rate lawyer in the great state of Texas. She will confirm the letter was signed. She knows nothing about me. A total con. It's far from the first time, of course, that he's derided a woman's appearance in public. As you may remember, when he was running for president in 2016 against a crowded field of Republican opponents, he had this to say in a Rolling Stone interview about Carly Fiorina, the former CEO who was running against him. Quote, look at the face. Would anyone vote for that? Can you imagine that? The face of our next president. Carly Fiorina is still active in leadership conferences, and she hasn't spoken about that horse face remark until now. I spoke with her just before airtime. Ms. Fiorina, I wonder, based on your own experience with then candidate Trump, what goes through your mind when you hear him refer to a woman as horse face?
Well, on the one hand, here he goes again. On the other hand, when people were shocked at Donald Trump's comments about my appearance, I wasn't, because he wasn't the first man to make comments about my appearance, positive or negative, and he won't be the last man to do so. I also want to distinguish, if I can, between the office of the presidency and the person who's in that office. There's no doubt that the office of the presidency is diminished when the occupant engages in this kind of insult over Twitter. On the other hand, when I think about the people involved here, Stormy Daniels, her lawyer, Donald Trump, I honestly think they're all birds of a feather. They're all in show business. And so while she's talking about his private parts, he's talking about her face, and they're all getting a lot of publicity.
It's interesting to me, this reporting, that the president actually kind of trial ballooned the insult to White House aides before he actually tweeted it, that he put kind of the forethought into these insults. I'm not sure what that says, but to me it was interesting that it wasn't just a spur of the moment thing.
Oh, I'm quite sure he did put thought into it. I think the habit of insulting one's political enemies is unfortunately longstanding in this country. And he has brought it to a new low, a fine art, whatever you like to say. There's no question that in politics, personal insults work, and they rile people up. And she is his adversary right now, and I'm sure there are a lot of people who like him taking a shot at her. I'm not one of them. I think it diminishes the office, and I think it's beneath him, and I think it diminishes all women. But it works with some people.
Does it frustrate you that there seem to be, on the Republican side, a fair number of women supporters of the president who seem to be okay with the president saying these things? Or is that, do you think that's people just making a political decision based on, you know, they like the agenda, and therefore they're willing to overlook things?
Well, I think there are some people, women or men, who are not willing to overlook things. I think there are others who make their decisions based on his agenda or his policies. But I'll tell you honestly, Anderson, what I'm more concerned about. What I'm more concerned about in all this talk is that we have made very little progress in terms of representation of women or people of color in positions of influence and impact and leadership over the last 25 years.
Yeah.
There are fewer women CEOs in the Fortune 500 than there are men named James. We haven't made enough progress. And so while I think it's important that we focus on the talk, because language has an impact and being disrespectful never helps the situation, I think we also need to focus on this startling reality that we're not making much progress in terms of toxic work cultures or the abuse of women or the underrepresentation of women and people of color in positions of impact and influence.
I think it's such an important point. I was talking to the CEO of Deloitte, who's a female, and she was saying, you know, we were discussing not only the small number, small percentage of CEOs who are women of Fortune 500 companies, but of women who are on boards of Fortune 500 companies.
Yes. In fact, the number is less than 20% of women on boards today, and that number, less than 20%, has not moved in 25 years. And yet, in that same 25-year period, record numbers of women have gone to business school and gone on to have careers. So there's something else going on here besides insulting language, although insulting language certainly doesn't help.
Looking ahead to the midterms, to this point that we've been talking about, there are a record number of women running for House and Senate seats. A large majority of them are Democrats. Why do you think there aren't more Republican women candidates out there running for these seats?
Well, you know, one of the things that I really regret is that women's issues has gotten politicized. That's a shame. I applaud any woman who runs for office. But truthfully, when I ran for office, there were many women who said I was an offense to women because I didn't share the agenda of a lot of the organizations, women's organizations, that happen to be left-leaning or Democrat. And so I do think that we ought to just acknowledge that when women are half the population, we have the same amount of diversity in our views as men do. And so it's unrealistic to expect all women to be Democrats or to agree with the Democrat agenda. I don't. And it's therefore not fair to condemn women who are conservatives or Republicans because they happen to be conservatives or Republicans.
Carly Fiorina, I appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thanks, Anderson.